Amen. Je believe that after today, someone, after today's church, as you are entering into life, that you are going to jubilate. That if you never jubilate before, or never experienced miracle before, or never tested this money before, you're going to test it next month. I want you to shout a big amen. Highest. Blessed is he that cometh in the name of the Lord. Holy, holy, holy Lord of hosts. You hope that is full of his glory. They are going to say, Jesus, the great conqueror and the mighty deliverer. He will deliver me today. We pray, those that are in God's prison, those that are in prison because of God's soul, for God to release me. In Jesus' name. Let us sit in holy places in Christ Jesus. And today someone is talking about focus on our Lord Jesus Christ. Father, we thank you as your children is about to hear your word. Focus on your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ. Without him, we can do nothing. Without him, we can do all things through only Jesus. Father, you said without him, nothing that was met in this world. As we are going to hear the word and they are going to focus us on Jesus from today, they are going to see miracles of Jesus in their lives. The imaginable, the wonderful miracle Jesus perfect in his days, they are going to express his life from today in Jesus' name. And as the word of God appears and they will be raptured, give them the grace to enjoy in this world and what to come on the last day. In the name of Jesus. And as they are hearing this word, any sin they are permitted to forgive, all our sins, conscious of the glory. They will put and accredit the righteousness of Jesus Christ into their life. All our righteousness are the picture right. Remember, you are the potter, we are the clay, and we are the voice of your hands. Prove your works in their lives from today. In Jesus' name. Jesus, focus on our Lord Jesus Christ. Because he is an unchangeable God. Because he is a great deliverer. Because he is the King of Kings. Because nothing you can do. He's the one that opened the seven seals. No other person. When everybody we are crying in heaven, who is worthy? Nobody. Bible says only him worthy to open the seven seals. That's why Jesus, there is a purpose Jesus brought us into this world. There is a purpose God brought to us. Two things very important: kingdom building and kingdom living. This is why we are created. Kingdom building, kingdom living. Live as a child of the kingdom. Build the kingdom. This is your doing here. You are building for the kingdom because nobody owns this property except God. Everything here is owned by God. So you are building the kingdom. That's why he created and live a kingdom living, a life as a son that is in the kingdom of God. That's why Bible tells us that God has transferred us from the kingdom of darkness into the glorious liberty of the kingdom of his Son, Jesus. That's why kingdom we are living. If you are not living a kingdom living, ask God. I want to live. Kingdom is not all that money. So we can have money and not have happiness. Don't have good health. Kingdom living happy. Jesus said, I will give you rest. Come unto me, come into the kingdom of Christ. You that are heavy laden. Rest is important. Money, that's why I said, seek ye first the same kingdom. The kingdom of God and his word, other things shall be added. Come into the kingdom first, then other things shall be added. So don't think what you will eat, what you will. Don't you think Bible says lilies of the field, they nobody if eat them, nobody they survive. They you who human be. Say you cannot ask him meat, he will give you snake. You cannot ask him egg, he will give you scorpion. Jesus said, you cannot ask me bread, I will give you stone. So Jesus is the only way. You focus on Jesus. Remove double-minded. You are here for kingdom living. Many people, they think of things of the carnal. They don't think the things of the kingdom. They think, what shall I eat? Food, money, house, clothing, how to satisfy my life. But there is one thing you're lacking to think. You don't, many people don't think of salvation. Many people don't think of eternal life. Many people don't think of rapture. Many people don't think of sin. Many people don't think of death. Many people don't think of evil spirits. How will you live about all material things? God will open your mind today. You start living as a kingdom believer. There are three things that are enemies of man. And there is one thing that is enemies of God. You expect that thing that is enemy of God is supposed to be your enemy. In the world, enemies of man are hunger, poverty and disease. Nobody likes hunger. Nobody likes to be poor. Nobody likes disease. And another thing that's added, death. Nobody likes that. If you hear that, you're going to run. But there is one thing that is enemy of God. That is what? Sin. And you supposed to hate it. It's not only God. This is what you are going to live. Then Jesus will be seen as a kingdom liver. God will give you the grace from today. Be a kingdom liver in Jesus' name. And I'm going to quickly open to the book of Acts of the Apostles 1, 8 to 11. 8. That is why Jesus came. In order to make us, reconcile us with God. He made sure that we are not separated from God. Before we were enemy of God, before sin separated us from God. But Jesus, the only way, he came and made us so that we not be separated from God. Reconcile us with God so that we be friends of God, we go direct to God. And also righteousness and holiness. That is very, very important. Without holiness, no one can see God. Bible says, as for the apostles, 1 verse 8, it says, you shall receive power. And Jesus is telling them here, the disciples, including you. Because there is a place we read in the Bible that says, if you believe in his word, if you continue in his word, you are his word disciples. So not only his disciples, including you. He said that you are going to receive power. What he said that you are going to use that power to do. There is something you are going to use that power to do. Many people receive power, they don't know what to do. God, Jesus said, you shall receive power when the Holy Spirit will come upon you. Many people receive power here, but they don't maintain it. Many people receive Holy Ghost. Worldliness will not allow like you. Alcohol, drinking, disco, reggae, worldliness will not allow you to train it. There is something God is telling you, you are going, when the Spirit of God come upon you, you are going to use the power to do. He said, you shall be my witness both in Jerusalem and in all Judea, Samaria, unto the uttermost parts of the earth. You are going to use it to be witness of just in Lashut, in Germany. Here at Jerusalem, talking to the disciple, you. What witness are you bearing? God, with the power the Holy Spirit you have. You use it to bear witness in Lashut, in Germany. If you're in Nigeria, you can even do it all over the world. Many people come life, you feel. Just enter life. We talk every day. That's what you're talking to Jesus. You're preaching gospel. Bear witness means testify of Jesus. Testify, bear witness of me. That is Jesus. How many people try to think about the kingdom? You go and sleep and say, God, I know I receive a lot of power. I don't maintain it. I don't trade it. How would I trade it? I say, I use it for you. Some people use money to bear witness. Some people want, you can use money to bear witness. There are people that cannot speak, that cannot preach. Their money is for kingdom building. Somebody that bought this is bearing kingdom witness of Jesus. Somebody that bought this is bearing witness of Jesus. When you come out and preach, you are bearing evangelist. Bear witness, make the whole world to know about Jesus. That is why you are created. That is the kingdom building. You help anything you can do to make the whole world to hear about who? Jesus. People make the whole world to know, hear about many, you know, all these positives that are, what things that are coming out. But you make God, make the whole world to hear about Jesus. All over, that is your mission in this world. Those countries all over the world, places, you know, people, when you see people going astray, going in a way that is not in the way of Jesus, call the person and tell what? Caution. Teach the person the way of righteousness, the way of the kingdom, to live a kingdom living. That is why you are created. Many of you receive power. You have power. You have power, but you don't use it. Many of you are doing an baptism. The power came upon you, but you don't know what to use that power to do. Many people, when they come out from the water, they receive power. It's not a must that when you do an baptism, come out, the power will come immediately. It comes immediately. It's not about that you start to manifest. It depends. Anybody that do immersion baptism, when you come and something follows you. When Jesus did his own, immediately came out, what happened? A dove. Bible said, all heaven do what? Opened. And the voice did what? Came out and said what? This is my beloved son, with whom I am well pleased. Bible said, dove came upon him. That is Holy Ghost. And Jesus said, the way my Father sent me, I sent you. So maybe when you come out, many things happen. It's not a moment. Something has happened in the realm of the spirit. There are different times, like when I did my own. The Holy Ghost. So there are people that when they came out, their own, the power came instant. There are people that when they came out, it will come, but it's not a moment you will manifest. You have the power. You go home and train it. And use it to do bear witness of Jesus. That is why God created you. People gather that look at the white that we are swimming, that are looking, collecting, getting fresh song. There's something like that's drama. But what happens out there is a spiritual something. So God will like you to use it to bear witness. Like after I received, I said, well, I'm not opening a church. I prefer going to German because every Sunday I will go to this evangelism in Egozin. I will go to the other one in the Nyakashtad. I'll be going, God telling me, open church. I say, God, no, he said that I must use it. I can't waste his power. So you have power. You have power. God will open your eyes. You will start bearing witness of the kingdom from today in Jesus' name. Bearing witness of Jesus from today. And I prophesy all of anybody doing immersion baptism now, may God help you to prepare yourself. Immediately you're coming out from water, let your gift manifest in action. In the name of Jesus Christ. That's why God created you to serve. When you open to the book of Mark 10:45. That is why God brought you. Bible says in Mark 1:45, for the Son of Man also came not to be ministered to. In King this faith, read it in King James. He has said minister to be served. But all to minister and to give his life. Read it, read it. Bring my people, give her so that you will hear it in King James version. The type of serving God wants is not recognized. Self, let me be recognized. It's a hidden one. Hidden service. Not a service, not the ones that you are working for, there are all service God means. Hidden one, serving God, working for him in secret. Bible says, he who sees you secretly, we do what? Reward you openly. To serve. That's why when you are with God, God will be you. Not everything somebody will use your sense to know certain things. When somebody is being offered to you, say no. Because there are some things that God reveals to you. God wants you to be that servant. So you are come to serve. You make sure you are serving. If you know that there is no way you are serving in the kingdom of God, you start from now. So God will give you the grace to start serving of the kingdom of God in Jesus' name. Amen. That's why when you finish, he's going to come and reward you for your job well done. When you open to the book of Revelation 22:4, 22:12, job well done. When he comes, he will reward you openly. Revelation 22:12 says, behold, I come what? Quickly. To do what? With my reward is with me. To come and reward you for the job well done. How you use the power he's gave you to bear his witness. How you use the Holy Spirit to give you to bear his witness. And reward you for the service you serve. Not to be served and to serve. He said he's going to reward you to render each man according to his work. There are people, their work is sharing. There is a message I saw in WhatsApp the other time. I was laughing. I said, hey, these people don't have what they're doing. They say, I saw pastor in hellfire. I said, who they tell on who go hellfire? Who they tell on all these things? We saw pastor. Which person who see hellfire come back to their life? I saw pastor. I said, these things, that messages are from witchcraft. God just wants you to criticize pastor. Because if you see people that are sharing in their life, it's even worse than pastor's life. The people that are sharing pastor's life, have them herself, they're all not even here by a piece of hell. There we go. The life they are here living, piece of hell. I was laughing. I said, that they don't understand. You see pastor in hellfire. Jesus said, that day you come to me and say, Lord, Lord, I prophesy in your name. I did miracle in your name. Jesus, God, Jesus will tell you, get behind me, I did not know you. Because in that message on WhatsApp, I had one that said, even the gifted pastors, gifted men of God, we are seen in the fire. Is it every pastor that is gifted is from God?
No.
So they have to say their English very well. Not all gifted pastors got your power from God. The reason why Jesus said that is that I tell you, get behind me, I don't know you. Say the English name. Lord, I prophesied in your name. I did miracle in your name. So what Jesus needs is that he said in my name. Tell him not to go and get power from you. He said, when that they say, I use your name to do it too. That them is what Jesus needs. I did this in your name. He start messing up in a way it goes to power, and that gift will disappear. So any person that say, see, give them pastor in hellfire. Any pastor run away from you. No pastor that is alive. Commit sin. God still come to you. Never. God is enemy of sin. That thing will separate until you make peace again with God. Start. So the ghost is not sharing, you are just promoting the kingdom of darkness. It's for those that are using marine power in the name of Jesus. Sisters, share messages that will make people to repent, to give their lives, to start working for the kingdom. God will give you the grace in Jesus' name. Then, finally, before we stop, when you open this book of James, 1:35, that's why Jesus said, when you are passing all this through all these things, count it all joy. Count it all joy. You know why? You know why God said count all joy? I put it on that. Yeah. Count it all joy. Because reason why God said count it all joy when you're passing through, because it will not last. There is no problem that lasts. No situation lasts. As far as I cry Jesus, it will not last. That's why Bible says many are the afflictions of the righteous. God deliver them all. See what James says, but he that looketh not the perfection of law, law of liberty, you are in the law of liberty, law of freedom, and so continue, be not a hearer that forgets, but a hearer that walketh. This shall man shall be blessed. People that hear the word of God and forget. This is what Bible says. A hearer not being a hearer that forgets. In letting you call this God, you have forgotten everything. You never put it in practice. The only thing that you hear that makes you to practicalize for God to bless you. He said, when you are such a person that forgets not the word of God, you shall be blessed. So people that are blessed, people that come to church, when they hear the word of God, they don't forget it. They put it. It will enter, they will swallow it. They will practicalize it. I said, continue, be not a hearer that forgets, but a doer of the word of God. Bible says, this man shall be blessed indeed. King James call it indeed. God is going to give you live a holy life, a life that will please God. Finally, faith, Thessalonians 4:11. Now that we please God. Just stop, you know, those people that are sharing those things. Calling to have busy people. Somebody just go to the internet and start using computer to confide hellfire. What comes to his mouth is pastor. That's why Bible says, and you study to be quiet and to do your own business and to do work with your hands as you are trying to. That is what Bible says. There is a version that calls it mind your own business. Stop for other people. Think for yourself. Think about your life. When the women of Philippines were crying for Jesus when Jesus was carrying cross, they were crying. What did Jesus tell me? Tell them, do not cry for me. Rather cry for yourself. So that's what I'm saying. Be quiet and do your own business. Mind your own business. Forget those things. Many people, where they are looking for their enemies, they don't know that. But there's an adage that says, your friends before your enemy hurt you. You know the meaning? Concentrate and be watchful to your friends before, because when you be watching your enemy will not hurt you. It's your friend. Before they get, they will come closer to you. Nobody can hurt you before. He will first of all come closer to you before he gets you. So you watch them. It's your friends you watch, not enemy. Before your enemy hurt you, you don't know that is your friends, is your enemy, that is the enemy. It's your friends you watch, not even enemy. Enemy is too far from you, can't near you. It's somebody that is near you can hurt you. Delilah and Samson. How did they get Samson? Through Delilah. Not better than this far. Near. They use that to know where the Samson power is and promise her money. So it's person Judas, they use Judas to get Jesus. So not far person, me. That's why Bible says your household is your enemy. So when your person that near you, when you're making friends, you have to be careful. Friends can't get you unless they come near to you. That's why I'm telling you, mind your own business. Stop sharing those things. Share good news of the gospel. Don't share something. Those things you're sharing is bringing the gospel down. There are people that can start, want to start church and repent. When they hear such messages, this church, I went to start, pastors, I went to hellfire. It's the message that witchcraft and the queen of the ghost and married spirit prepared in order to bring down the mind of people that want to come to God. So God will give you the grace to start building for the kingdom in Jesus' name. Stand up as we are going to pray.
Move your shy.
Begin to thank God for today's sermon. Begin to thank God for making you to be alive. Yeah, for someone to make you to be a kingdom builder. Thank God for giving you Jesus. Thank God from today. You will start being why he created you, a kingdom builder and a kingdom believer, a kingdom liver. that from today they want to start building kingdom and they want to start living as a kingdom. That God, I want you to do me, give me, make me to become a millionaire and bless me. That when you bless me, I'm going to use the money